What up, guys? So I thought I would come on and share this look with you all. So I know it's not going to suit everyone, and then obviously I wouldn't go outside looking like this, but yeah, since it's the summer festival season, I thought I would come on already and have a full face of festival makeup already created for y'all and not letting out the hairstyle. So I have this hairstyle that I recently created. So it was just fast to do, so I just did it there like 2 minutes ago. But anyhow, it does not suit me and I know that, but I've seen like so many hairstyles with like these kind of buns. So I said, why not? I'll tag along. So yeah, today, just starting out, I'm just going to let you all know the products that I used. Well, some of the products, and I won't be showing you all how I created this look because I have like done another festival look, and yeah, so we haven't really requested it on my channel yet, so I said I would just get right into the video and have it created already. So if you're interested, then stay tuned. So the products that I use to create this look are nothing really major. I kind of use a bit of everything and anything really, but yeah, I feel so weird having my hair like this, but, you know, I'll get there. It's really childish for me, but it's actually currently so in right now, and the glitter lining, please dash my roots. Oh my god, they're so bad right now. And I only done them a couple of weeks ago, so yeah. So if you're wondering what glitter I'm using on my eyelids, and my lips, so I apply it up to my lips as well. I'm actually using this little glitter here. So I don't have a name specifically on this little glitter, but it's actually yellow, as you can see. I ordered this from AliExpress and I got like 12 in the pack, and they were only like €3. So I said, why not? Yeah, had to get them. So it was my first time using the yellow today, and I thought it would kind of, you know, give me this cool festival look, and yeah. That's what I achieved. Hope you like it, but anyhow, I'm liking it. I really like this look, but I'm not too keen on the hair because it makes me look really childish, but anyhow. So that was the glitter. If you watched yesterday's video, I filmed a video using my new lipstick, but I only used one, so this is another lipstick. So this was the one that's in the shade Strip. And I actually have it on right now. So I'm pretty impressed with that. If you haven't watched the video, then just scroll down, you'll see it. It was a new video uploaded, so yeah. I don't really know if it's focusing, but I hope it is. This is the new lipstick that I purchased. I ordered 3, and yeah, this is my first time wearing this shade. Really liking it. It's like a Barbie-ish pink shimmer shine. So the foundation that I wore today, I'm back using my Inglot. So I used Inglot foundation in the shade LC 300. So yeah, I actually was pretty devastated when I applied this, because I always apply this, I always wear it, but then I stopped wearing it, moved to using another foundation, and now I use this today. I actually moisturized beforehand as well, so my skin was not dry, and then like my foundation was just sliding on my face and wasn't giving me full coverage at all. So I don't think I'll be using this again. Nah. So then I used concealer. I used a L'Oreal Concealer True Match. So I used this one for like, do you know, to clean up the brow area. And then I moved back to using my fave, which this is the Eraser Eye. So everyone is using this one, and it's in the shade Nude. So everyone loves this concealer. If you're a lover, then comment below. So was just this one here in the shade Nude. So I used that for like throughout all of my face, and yeah, it gave me full coverage and it kind of helped me, like it helped my foundation as well, because as I said, my foundation was pretty bad. It was patchy, wasn't giving me full coverage. Then when I applied this, like I'd apply this on my chin, above my lip area, my nose line, the bridge of my nose, and under my area and my forehead, and it cleaned up my foundation nicely, so I'm pretty impressed. I obviously needed my blender, so please dash the dirtiness of this. So I used my blender to apply the OVS. And what else did I use? So I'm just looking at them. Oh yeah, so to apply my bronzer, I actually use these two products right here. So this is the brush that I recently purchased also. I also have a video up of this little bad boy, so check it out. Yeah, there's a hair hanging up, but anyhow. So yeah, this bronzer is like a shimmery, really chocolatey brown. I think I might go back to start using a lighter brown, because this is too much for me, I think. Let me know what you think. Sorry now guys, I'm just looking. So I actually used my NYC Brow Kit, so I actually need to use my Sleek in future, because I wasn't happy with this brow finish result at all. No, I didn't like it. It's not shading in my brows like fully, and I'm not happy with the shape, so I don't think I'll be using this like again. I'd rather the Sleek, because the Sleek gives you full coverage brows.
Brows on Sleek all day long.
So then moving on, I used this brand, the BAM Cosmetics. So I recently told y'all about this. It's amazing, oh my god. And I don't really know what I used to apply it, actually. I think it was this brush here. It's just an enormous, normal foundation brush, bronzer brush, whatever you like to use it. So I used this Betty Lau Manizer. So I used this like shimmery bronzer for like a highlight. So you get like the white shade, the pink, and the brown. So I used the brown. I don't really know if I like it quite yet, so I'm not going to give you my opinion. But usually I would use like the white or a shade. And it's so, so pigmented. Oh my god. I don't know if you can see that. 1 minute. So I usually use this one. And then today then I used the brown one, which I don't think I'll be using again. So yeah, but this is so pigmented, guys. The brown, I'm not saying the brown's bad, but I just don't like the brown. I'd rather the white, because I wear like brown. Like I do my contour brown anyway, so, you know. Then today I have this eyeshadow palette that I have not used in so long. So today I decided I would go back and use it. I ordered it from AliExpress, and I just ordered it because it was really affordable and I really liked the shades in it, and I thought they would create really good looks. But then I just stopped using it for some reason. I think because my sister got her hands on it, I don't know. But yeah, there's 15 colours in it, and this is it outside. So this is the little palette, and it says you can be, what the fuck. So anyhow, I don't know what that means, but when you look inside, they have really nice like spring winter tones, pigments. So I was really happy with the colours, so I said I would purchase. And I haven't really used the cranberry reddish pinky colour here, so I said today that I will go in and use it. And as you can see, I have. So I've used that cranberry colour for above, like, you know, for my base of my eyes. And I was pretty impressed, to be fair. Yeah, I thought it would go really nice with the yellow as well, and go kind of like break it, you know, go cray cray. So yeah, I'm really impressed with that colour. So this is the shade here. It doesn't have like the shade, but this is the colour of the shade that I used. So yeah, and I also added in some orange for here. to kind of outline it more. So you can't really see it because it blends in quite nicely and naturally, so you wouldn't really notice. But yeah, I also used this shade here. So I used orange, so I'm really loving orange and reds lately. So yeah, I used this also. And then I used some normal, well, I never use like eye pencil, black eye pencil underneath my eyes. So I usually use like any kind of eyeshadow. So today for under my eyes, I used eyeshadow here in black to get my eyeliner on there. And I also went in with this orange again and applied some before I put in my black. So yeah. That's a really good palette, affordable, and I'm really loving the colours. And I'm definitely going to be using this cranberry red, pinky tone, to create other colours also. And I'm really delighted that I applied it today because now I can achieve lots more looks with it, seeing that I'm happy with it. What else? I'm just looking now, guys, to see what other ones I used. Oh. Where is it? Oh yeah, so for my mascara today, I'm not wearing any like, so I'm not wearing any winged liner in black. So I thought I would go in today. One second, is the mod for it? So I just thought I'd go today with some, I don't know where it is actually, but. So I thought I would go in today, there it is. Instead of using black, as you guys know, I always use black and I always go, but you know, it kind of gives me that kind of same look. And I've seen girls create looks with no liquid eyeliner and I was like, how do they get their eyes so nice? And I'm glad I went in without it. So today I thought I would try out a different liquid liner and I used this little one here, it's silver. And the brand is Makeup Gallery Chick Flick Eyeliner. And it's in the shade Silver Glitz 5. So I decided that I would go in and just apply some to the inner corners of my eyes. And add my wing and also create a little symbol up here using this liquid eyeliner. And I obviously went overboard and decided I would outline my lips with also using this eyeliner. So yeah, you might kind of think I'm crazy, but yeah, I like being creative. And when I created my last festival look, I said that I like being creative and that I would be trying out more. So I didn't lie. So this is my last product. I'm going to show how I created my makeup look. And yeah, so if you're wondering why I'm not wearing lashes, it's because I don't have any duo glue at the moment. My sister is to blame for that. But yeah, she also robbed my favorite mascara, which is the Ingla. I always use the Ingla and it gives me like a full, you know, gives me full lashes. And I just imagine I don't have to wear fake eyelashes when applying that mascara. So I just use some cheap mascara today. It was only like $1.49 from a pound shop, and yeah, it kind of did work, you know, it did the job, I guess, especially for under my eyes, so I can't complain. So yeah, guys, that's my look for today, my makeup look. I hope you enjoyed it. Please request more festival looks down below. Because as you guys know, I said in my last video, I love creating these kind of looks. And it's really fun as well because I can come out of my comfort zone and go cray cray for y'all. And I love these colours and I also get to experiment with a lot of crazy makeup, pigments, colours, etc. So before I stop this video, I just want you all to know that this hairstyle is simple. It's super easy to create. You just half your hair, so get a comb and half your hair all the way up and back and down. So then you come along with your hairbrush. My hairbrush has so much blonde hair in it right now. Oh my god, my hair is falling out so bad. But anyhow, please about it. So I just grabbed my hair and tied it up into a high ponytail, and then I also did the same for the other side, obviously. And then I just got it and grabbed it tightly and swung it around and around and around, depending on how long your hair is. My hair is pretty long. So yeah, I kind of had to do it a few times. Then just get some of your grips. Where are they? I have some mirrors. So bobby pins, they do wonders. That's what I'm using. So I've been using bobby pins to clip them in, and they're so tight, foam. They're so tight and they're just not budging. So yeah, this is a really cool look. It does go quite well with my makeup, but I will not be going outside like this. No way. Maybe to a festival, but I don't think I'll be going to a festival anytime soon. But anyways, guys, if you guys enjoyed this look and would love to create it, then please let me know your thoughts on it. And if you have tried to create this look, and please, 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 if you're on Instagram, my Instagram is at Nikki Harty in capital letters all together. Tag me in your looks. I would love to see what you guys achieved. I didn't look at anything online. I just went in for it and created this look myself and used whatever products that I gathered that I could find. So yeah, but I really enjoy creating this look, guys, and I hope you enjoyed watching it. If not, then go. If so, then smash this video with a thumbs up, and please don't forget to subscribe. Till next time, guys. Bye.